WJCL News, working for you.
New developments in the case of Randall Roach Sr. He's the man accused of running the gambling ring from former Metro Chief Willie Lovett that he helped cover up.
Randall was in court twice today to enter a plea. WJCL's Nick Notario just got out of the courtroom and he is joining us with the very latest. Nick, what have we learned?
Yeah, some real explosive evidence just came out of the courthouse. I literally just came outside about 5 minutes ago. So here's what happened. Randall Roach this morning pleaded not guilty to two charges of illegal gambling and conspiracy. Well, he just pleaded guilty to the conspiracy charge, and the illegal gambling charge was dismissed. Now, in the plea hearing, the prosecutors said that during this whole time, for the past 10 years, Roach had operated illegal gambling around the southeast, South Carolina, including many stops here in the Savannah area, including the help of former Metro Police Chief Willie Lovett. Now, it alleges an FBI informant tipped them off that there was going to be illegal gambling around St. Patrick's Day 2013. So the FBI had wiretaps and was watching a trailer, which was on MLK and Bay Street, and they say they observed former Chief Lovett pulling up in a black SUV at least five times during that period and received cash payments from Roach in exchange of not telling them or getting them in trouble and allowing them to do the illegal gambling. Now, this happened again in May of 2013, they say, when an informant went to the gambling site, lost money on purpose, and called 911. When the call came through and officers were on their way to the scene, they say that Lovett moved them away so that way they could continue their illegal operation. Now, Roach is going to be facing 5 years, but for his cooperation, he could receive a lesser sentence. Also in the courtroom were Lovett's attorneys. They told us that there are two sides of a story, and obviously this thing happened very fast. He pleaded not guilty, remember, this morning, and then took the plea deal this afternoon. So they're a little fishy, they think, as to how this whole thing came about. Now, there's been no date set for Lovett's next court appearance, but we're going to have a lot more details. As I mentioned, this just wrapped up, so stick with us. But for now, reporting live in downtown Savannah, Nick Notario, WJCL News, working for you.